And the weight?
59
kilograms, okay. Perfect. Okay, your hand seems to be a bit cold at the end. It could mean a poor blood circulation. Okay. Also behind your ears. Perfect.
I will be visualizing the optic cup, an optic disc.
And also now I'm going to press against your head. Perfect. Great. That's awesome. Now we are going to try to I'm going to osculate the abdomen in all four quadrants. I'm going to palpate your hip joints and you will bend forward for me. I'm just going to look at your back. Bend forward, to the ground, perfect, up, great. Do you have any back pain problems?
No.
Okay. Hi, my name is Dr. Kevas and I will be doing your full body examination today. Is that all right with you? Perfect. So first I'm going to look at you and assess you. So the patient seems mentally alert, which is great. Also seems to be in a no immediate distress. Perfect. So I'm looking at the height and weight. So approximate height is about 170 centimeters. And the weight could be about 58 kilograms. Perfect. So I'm just going to write it down. Looks mentally alert, no signs of immediate distress. Height is about 170. What is the precise height of yours?
So 168 centimeters.
Perfect. And the weight?
59
kilograms. Okay. Perfect. So that looks great. We are first going to start with a few questions, okay? We're going to try a memory and a cognition assessing. Okay, so could you please first state your full name?
So, my name is Mary Stone.
Mary Stone, okay, perfect. I'm just going to write that down. Okay, what is the month and the day?
So, it is February and Monday today.
Okay, perfect. And could you tell me where are we at this moment?
So, we are
in the studio.
In the studio.
Right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Perfect. Okay, I'm going to give you three words to remember. Mm-hmm. It's going to be pink, sky, and rocket. I want you to repeat those words.
So, pink, sky, and rocket.
Perfect. And you are going to remember these three words for, I don't know, approximately 30 seconds. So let's repeat them once more.
Pink, sky, and rocket.
Perfect. So I'm going to ask you some really silly questions. Could you tell me what virus there was for the past few years?
So a coronavirus.
Yeah, that's perfect. And could you tell me what university is the most known in Czech Republic?
So, and the Charles University in Prague.
Okay, and what color is the grass?
Green.
Perfect, that's great. And could you tell me those three words I gave you to remember?
So, pink, sky, and rocket.
Okay, that's great. Okay, now you are going to touch your nose, like so. And I'm going to have my finger, and you are going to touch it and put it back, okay? And you will do so until I tell you to stop.
Okay.
Okay, so let's start. Perfect. Now stop and switch hands. Okay, perfect. Perfect, stop. Great. Now we are going to try sharp and dull test. I'm going to take one thing that is sharp and one thing that is dull, okay? Okay, so this part, is it sharp?
Dull. Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to try this. Is this sharp?
Yeah.
Perfect. And this? Is it dull?
Sharp.
Sharp, okay. Then I'm going to try only this. This will be sharp, mm-hmm. Okay? And this will be dull.
Okay.
Okay, or we can try something else. You can try something else. I'm going to try with this. This is going to be sharp.
Mm-hmm.
This is going to be dull.
Okay.
Okay, so let's start. You just close your eyes and tell me.
Sharp. Dull. Sharp. Dull. Sharp.
Mm-hmm.
Sharp.
Perfect.
Dull.
Sharp.
Sharp.
Doesn't okay. matter.
And dull.
Yes, perfect. That's great. Okay, so now we are going to move to checking your vitals, which are actually your pulse checking. I'm going to try it on your other hand since you have there your okay. watches. I'm going to just press the radio now and count for 15 seconds and count the pulse, multiply it by 4. Perfect. Now the same with your respiration. I'm going to look at your respiration and multiply it by 4. Okay. Everything seems to be fine. That's perfect. That's great. So now that we have the pulse checking, we are going to do a general skin inspection, which means that I'm going to look at the color, temperature, texture, and also some other things. Okay, so first I'm just going to look at you and assess the color of your skin, which seems to be normal for your ethnicity. There doesn't seem to be any kind of rash. I'm just going to look into the inner side of your hand. Okay. Nothing there, perfect. Could you lift up your arms? Okay, perfect. Great. I'm going to look at your neck. You can put your arms down. Okay, so the neck seems to be also good. You are wearing a full makeup. Do you have any kind of problems with rash or anything like that? Okay, perfect. So now we are going to try the Turger test. Okay. So the elasticity is great. I'm going to try the temperature. I'm going to touch you and look if the temperature is the same. Okay, your hand seems to be a bit cold at the end. It could mean a poor blood circulation. Perfect. Okay, so texture also. Okay, so it seems that the texture is great. Her skin is very smooth. Okay, very smooth and hydrated. Perfect. So now we are going to do a visual inspection of your facial features. I'm going to ask you to do some silly faces for me. So you are going to raise your eyebrows. Okay, now you are going to puff your cheeks like that. Now clench your teeth. American smile. Perfect. Okay, that seems great. Also, could you please stick out your tongue? Perfect. That's great. So cranial nerve number 7 is intact. Now I'm going to look at your scalp and also your skull. We are going to look at the hair pattern and hair distribution. Okay. I'm also going to look for any lesions, lumps and bumps. Okay, so no hair loss. Balding. That's great. I'm going to ask you to bow a little bit in front and put your hand like this. I'm going to be palpating your head, looking for any lumps and bumps. Okay. Also behind your ears. Perfect. That's great. Now we are going to palpate your facial bones. We will start with the frontal sinuses, which are above the eyebrows. Perfect. Then the maxillary sinuses, which are right here. Okay, any pain when I press? Any pain when I press here? No, perfect. Now we're going to look at the TMJ. I'm going to put my hands right here and you will open your mouth and then you will move the jaw from side to side, okay?
Okay.
So, okay, could you open the... Perfect, and move it from side to side. Perfect, you can close your mouth. Perfect. And you are going to clench your jaw. Perfect. So that is also fine. Okay. Now I'm going to take my furry ball. It's really light to touch. Can you feel it? Okay, every time I touch you, you say now you will close your eyes and tell me when you feel it.
No. No.
Okay. That's done. Great. So now we are going to look at your eyes. I'm going to shine a bright light in your eyes a little bit later. First, I'm just going to look at them normally. I'm just going to pull down your eyelids. Okay, I'm looking at the conjunctiva. It seems to be pink and moist. Your sclera seems to be white, which is perfect. There is no sign of yellow. Perfect. We are now going to try the visual acuity test. I have there a Sneller chart. I will hold it in this distance and you will read the letters. I will point. Okay, so what is this?
P-O-P-E-T. P, F, P, L.
Perfect. That's fine. So we will put away the Sneller chart. So the visual acuity is perfect. Now we will try the pupillary response, direct and consensual. I'm going to shine a bright light into your eyes and I will look at the pupils as dilating and constricting, okay? So let's just start. Perfect. So this was the direct. And I'm going to... Perfect. Great. That's fine. Now we are going to shine the light from the side, okay? And I will look at the We'll be visualizing the optic cup, an optic disc. Okay, the border seems to be pretty clear. Perfect. The other eye. Okay, perfect. The same on the other eye. Great. I'm going to shine a light from the side. Okay, and I'm looking at the corneal reflection, and it's the same on both eyes. Now I'm going to shine again from your side and look for a crescent shadow. Okay, nothing there. No signs of crescent shadow. That's perfect. Okay. Now we are going to look at your eyes real close. There is no sign of nystagmus, which is actually an involuntary movement, okay, of your eyes. There is none, okay, in any direction. That's great. So both eyes are intact bilaterally, perfect. So now we are going to do extraocular movements. I'm going to ask you to follow my finger. You will keep your head straight. You will not move it anywhere. You will just follow my finger with your eyes. Perfect. Do you happen to have any double vision? Okay, that's great. Okay, now we are going to try hearing tests. I'm going to put on my gloves. I will ask you again to close your eyes. Tell me when you hear anything. And lift the hand that you hear the sound on which side, okay? Perfect. Perfect. Great. Great. Now I'm going to whisper three or two words. It can be absolutely random things such as numbers, colors, basically anything. To try the same thing. I'm just going to be doing a little bit of noise, okay? Heart.
Heart.
Pop.
Pop.
Light.
Light.
Pen.
Pen.
Perfect. So the hearing seems to be pretty fine. That's great. We are going to try a little test. It's called our Rene and Weber's test. I'm going to take my tuning fork and place it on the middle of your forehead. And you will tell me where you feel the distribution, okay, of the vibration. And then I will press it here, okay, behind your ears. You will also tell me when you stop hearing the sound, okay? Okay, so first off, where do you feel it? Do you feel it same on both sides?
Yeah.
Perfect. Great. Now I'm going to try the bone conducting test. Tell me when you stop hearing it. Okay, can you hear it now?
Yeah.
Perfect. Do the same on the other side. Tell me when you stop hearing it.
No.
Can you hear it?
Yeah.
Perfect. Perfect. I'm going to look into your ear really fast. I'm going to take my to bright a light, shine a bright light into your ear. Now we'll look inside your ear canal, okay? I'm just going to take it like this. I'm going to put my hand. Okay, perfect. It seems to be fine. The other side. I'm going to just switch my hands and look into the ear. Perfect. Great. That's great. So, ears are great. Eardrums are easily visible. There was a light reflection at the end. Great. So now I'm going to actually palpate your nasal bones and also the cartilage to see if it moves from side to side. Perfect, and it does. I'm going to look into your oral cavity. If I could ask you to open your mouth, I'm just going to shine a light into your mouth, and you are perfect. Everything seems to be fine. So now we are going to do a neck inspection, which means I'm going to first look at your body posture. It seems to be great. It seems that you exercise a lot and you have a great back muscles. Okay, perfect. So we are looking for fullness and symmetry. Now we are going to try the range of movement of your neck. So if I may ask you to put your head a little bit forward. Okay, and now backward. Now to your shoulder. Now to the other side. Perfect. That's great. Now if you could move your head into the side like so, and to the other side. Great, that's perfect. Now we are going to try your cranial nerve number 11, and you are going to press your shoulders against my hands. Perfect, that's great. And also now I'm going to press against your head. Perfect. Great. That's awesome. Now I'm going to actually palpate your lymph nodes. So we'll start on here. Okay, here. Okay. Now the supraclavicular. Perfect. That's great. I'm going to palpate your artery. Check for pulse now on the other side. Perfect. Great. Now we are going to look at your tracheal positioning, okay? I'm going to have to palpate your thyroid. And we will try the flexibility. Perfect. I'm going to palpate it again. And you will swallow. Can you swallow? This. Perfect. That's great. Okay, so now we are going to proceed to upper extremity inspection. So I'm going to palpate your clavicles, your shoulder joints, bicep, tricep, forearms, and also your wrists. So let's start. I'm going to put your hair back. Then I'm going to
I'll pay your clinicals. Okay, that's great. I'm going to palpate your visa. If you feel any discomfort, just tell me, okay? Okay, now we're going to look at the carpal bones. Okay, perfect. I'm sleepy joints.
Any pain? Okay. Now the PIP. And DIP. Perfect. Now the other hand. Okay, any pain? No, that's great. Now we're going to try the range of your movement. I'm going to ask you to put your hands behind your back, like so, perfect. Now above your hand, perfect. Now here, now backwards as much as you can. Perfect, perfect. Now you are going to put your elbow like this, perfect, great. Now I'm going to give you my finger. You will press the tip of the finger with one of your hands. Now with the other. Perfect. Now I'm going to give you two of my fingers and you will squeeze them as tightly as you can. Perfect. The other. Great. Perfect. So this seems to be fine. Now we are going to try the resistance test. You are going to have your elbows like this and I'm going to be trying to get them away from you and you will resist me, okay? Okay, now to the other side. Perfect. Now, you will have your hands like this and I will press on them and you will again try to resist me. Perfect. Now the other side. Perfect. Great. That seems to be fine. Okay, so now what we are going to do is actually a pulmonary inspection. I will ask you to turn around and... Perfect. And you will actually lift your shirt up as much as you can so that I can actually see your lungs. Perfect. I'm going to put it here, like so. That's great. So. First, breathe normally as you can. You can put your arms down. That's great. I'm going to lift this up. Perfect. And breathe. Deep breath in. Exhale out. Perfect. So I'm also looking at the skin. Everything seems to be normal. There is no scarring. There is no erythema, no rash or anything. Perfect. The lung expansion seems to be great. Now I'm going to actually percuss. Okay, I'm going to ask you to take your shirt off if that's possible for the moment. Perfect. Okay. Now we are going to try to podcast the lung field. That's great. Okay, and now I'm going to take a listen. I will ask you to take a deep breath in and exhale out. Again. I'm going to ask you to put your shirt back on. I'm going to keep it here. And we are going to look at your anterior chest. So if I may ask you to turn around again. you are going to palpate your clavicles, sternum, upper and lower ribs, okay? So I'm going to be palpating here, then here, also here, and here. Sternum. Perfect. Now the ribs, the upper ribs, and the lower ribs. Perfect. Perfect. So everything seems to be fine. I'm also going to paracast the anterior chest. Everything seems to be fine in the pulmonary inspection. Now we will try your heart inspection. Okay, I will try it with both sides of my stethoscope. So I'm going to take it here. Okay, so your heart is on this side, so we are going to places. First is here. Perfect. Now here. Great. Now from the bottom. Perfect. And here. Perfect. That's great. So your heart seems to be fine and healthy. Now we are going to proceed to abdominal inspection. So I'm going to take my things away. And you will lie down on your back. That's perfect. So, since I'm going to look at your abdomen, I will pull your shirt up, okay? I'm going to take this and this, and that's probably everything I need. Okay, so now we are going to do an abdominal inspection, which means I'm going to pull your shirt a little bit up and your shorts a little bit down so that I can actually really see the abdomen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull it away like this. Okay, and we'll try to keep it there. Perfect. And we are going to look for, I'm going to ask you to put your knees a little bit up. Perfect. To look for any masses, hernias or pulsations. Okay, now try to lift your head a little bit. Okay, so there is no hernia, perfect. So first off, I'm going to auscultate the abdomen in all four quadrants. positive bowel movements, which is great in all four quadrants. So now I'm going to bypass all four quadrants. Tell me if you feel any discomfort. So now I'm going to actually be looking for your liver, which should be in this quadrant. I will go down your ribs and it should be somewhere right here, okay? It is approximately 6 to 12 centimeters big. Okay, so it's about here, which is perfect. I'm going to be lightly palpating your abdomen. If you feel any pain, just tell me so, okay? We will go a little bit more deep. I'm going to palpate your spleen. It can actually be a little bit uncomfortable. So, okay, I've got it. Now your kidneys. You can now sit down. So now we are going to do your lower extremity inspection. So I'm going to look at your legs basically. I'm going to ask you to have your hair. Okay, so I'm looking at color, no discoloration again. Okay, perfect. I'm going to try the temperature again. Okay, perfect. I'm going to just put your socks down. So I'm going to palpate your thighs. If you feel any pain, just tell me. Behind your knees. Great. Perfect. Your calves. That's great. Perfect. Now the Achilles tendon. Same as previously, the temperature at the toes seems to be a little bit colder. Same as in your hands. Perfect, I'm just going to write my notes down. Now we are going to try the range of motion and mobility. And also, again, a resisting test. So I will put my hands here and you will try to lift up your knees, okay? Can we do so? Perfect. And now on the other side, just push down. Perfect. That's great. So now I'm going to ask you to lie down again. Yeah, on your back. Perfect. And we are going to try the test of motion range. So I'm going to take your leg like this. I'm going to keep it straight and just try to. Perfect. Now the other one. Now knee to your chest. Inward, outwards, and like this. Perfect. And the other one. Into your chest. Away from your chest. Here. Again, away and like so. Perfect. That's great. You can sit down again. Now try to extend your leg like so. Now the other one. Perfect. Now keep it up. And try to resist me. Okay, perfect. Now just try to push against me again. Now to the other side. Perfect. Now again here. Perfect. And there. Great. Now you are going to press with your feet against mine. Other side. Perfect. Now try to do with your leg this and this. We are trying the dorsiflexion. Yeah, perfect. That's great. Now you are going to try to take the soles of your feet together, which means that you will put them together like this. Great. Perfect. Can you take just your big toe up? Perfect. Great. And can you also put it down? Perfect. And now all your fingers up and down. Perfect. That's great. Perfect. Perfect. Okay. I'm going to ask you to stand. And you will walk for me from here, okay, to here, right to me. I will look at how you walk, again back to me. Perfect. So now you are going to go with your back to me. I'm going to palpate your hip joints and you will bend forward for me. I'm just going to look at your back. Bend forward to the ground, to the ground. Perfect. Up. Great. Now go to the side like this. Perfect. Now do the other side. Perfect. And now back to me. Like this. Perfect. Okay, and back. That's great. You can sit down again. So, I was looking at your back. There is no sign of kyphosis, lordosis, or scoliosis, which means that your spine has the right curvature. But for now, I will ask you again to turn around and I will palpate the spine. Okay, I will ask you again to take down your shirt. Perfect. You don't have to, well, doesn't matter. Okay. So I'm just going to palpate your spine. Do you have any back pain problems?
No.
Okay. Okay, now the spine itself. From the neck. Any pain? Any tenderness? Okay, perfect. I'm going to palpate your ribs as well. Perfect, and I'm going to percuss. and also palpate the shoulder blades. Okay, the scapula seems to be fine. Perfect, you can take your shirt back up. Okay, so it seems that you are a healthy young woman that has no problems, which is pretty much good for you. So thank you for being a part of this examination. And hopefully see you next time.
Okay, thank you.
Bye.
Bye.